In San Francisco, University of California Regents are beginning a series of meetings that could lead to tuition hikes across the UC system. And in Santa Cruz, UCSC is getting ready for the backlash.
Take it back! Take it back! Take it back!
This was the scene today as students are already beginning their protests over the proposed 8% hike in tuition. That's on top of the previous year's 32% increase. Action News reporter Phil Gomez was on campus for today's protest. He joins us live from our Santa Cruz newsroom with more.
Well, last year, fee hikes led to violence and students damaging at least one UCSC campus building. The school is hoping to head off a repeat occurrence from angry students.
Take it back! Take it back! Take it back! Take it back!
UC Santa Cruz students, faculty, and employees are screaming mad over proposed changes to retirement benefits and an 8% hike in student fees.
Struggling for a better future, because if I ever honestly want to entertain having children and having them have a chance to go to the UC California, you know, University of California, I'd have to really fight right now.
The people united will never be divided.
What started as a rally soon turned into a march as students wound through the UC Santa Cruz campus, slowing traffic along McLaughlin Road as they made their way to the University Center.
Students are being picked on, they're being shaken down for their money. Same kind of things happening to employees. We're getting effective pay cuts, or at least that's what the threat is at the bargaining table today.
Occupy! Occupy! Occupy!
Students took over the University Center restaurant for about 20 minutes. Those inside had mixed feelings about the takeover.
It was crazy. That was the first time I've ever seen them occupy something live, and it was pretty cool.
They were doing it all the time last year. They took over Kerr Hall. I mean, they've been doing it and hasn't really done anything.
Protesters say this plan of action isn't going unnoticed.
I think there's no question about that. The Schwarzenegger and Senate leaders in California cited the demonstrations that we had last year, and we got $600 million that sort of disappeared into the ether of the UC administration.
When students began their protest, the doors were locked at Clark Kerr Hall, where the school administration is located. They didn't want a repeat of last year when students occupied the building for several days.
Just as a precaution, there, as you recall, the last time this happened, there were about 100 employees who were displaced from the workplace for several days. So that's obviously something we want to avoid.
After protesters left the restaurant, they marched to Quarry Plaza, where they voted to disperse rather than cause any further disruption. There were no arrests. Back to you in the studio.
All right, Phil, thank you. The rally did coincide with the beginning of the Board of Regents meeting held in San Francisco today. Students do plan to drive to San Francisco tomorrow and continue their protests there, where the Regents are scheduled to vote on the increases on Thursday.